Let's continue on now. We've gone through the first three sections. We're up to cruising along, and we look out the window, and we know that it's about time to pick up an IFR clearance. See the weather starting to build. We can go along and check weather now and see what we need to do, set up the approach, do all the en route stuff that we can do to make the descent and approach portion of the flight a lot easier going, and our situational awareness will be extremely enhanced if we go ahead and get set up early and get completely oriented. I begin by switching over if I know I'm going to get in the IFR environment. I go to the map options page with the chart selected, and I select my low altitude terminal. Since I'm below 18,000 feet, I wanted to be on the low altitude charts. That's most of the time we'll get intersections like that. On a rare occasion, ATC will clear us direct to a fix that's not annotated on a low chart, be it an arrival or an area fix or a high altitude. But this is the best place to start when we're flying in the low altitude environment. I also like to make sure that I'm navigating at this point on the radio that I want to navigate on. In the last segment, we went ahead into the 650 and set up, put Gainesville in as our one of our points. And in the internal flight plan, we made it the active point going direct to Gainesville. And Niner Alpha Zero Dahlonega was our initial point. So that's where we are now. We're setting up our radios and getting ready to change our destination. Under the flight plan page now, I can go in and start pulling up my waypoint details, check the weather, get all the frequencies at Gainesville, see which approach we're going to shoot, and get underway of setting up the aircraft for the descent. So once we pull up the details page at Gainesville, I'll go down to the bottom and I want to look at the frequencies. And it will bring up a list of the weather frequencies. So Gainesville, the CTAF, I can set that in as my communications backup. The ASOS, we'll go ahead and set that in. And we're IFR now, so I don't really need the center or approach departure control frequencies. But I wanted, initially, I want to check the latest weather at my destination and decide what approach that we want to set up for. Also at the bottom of the details page, there's a plate button. We'll go ahead and press that. And that will bring up the list of the approach plates stored for Gainesville. With the wind direction and the ceiling and everything and the direction we're coming in from, I want to go ahead and load and set up for the RNAV or GPS approach to runway 23 at Gainesville. So let's go ahead and do that and push the view button. And that will bring the approach plate up on the left side. It'll displace the PFD. We'll still be in the map mode on the right side. That's the default setting for viewing an approach plate. Now you will notice that down on the bottom, we've got the in-out rotate list. We've got left and right and up and down on the two external knobs. So we can manipulate the plate, put it where we want it, blow it up to where we can read the notes and just familiarize ourselves with the plate and make sure that's the correct one that we want to look at. Also, you'll notice that the traffic is off and on where we have it on. And I'll talk about that in just a second, as you can toggle the traffic on and off on the approach plate. Just be advised that this has nothing to do with the traffic on any of your map pages, nor on your attitude indicator, the ABI. Will always display the traffic regardless of the position of this software switch here. Now this is just a close-up in and out list that are on the switches. I can zoom in. I can go back and bring up another list of the approach plates. I can rotate it, which I haven't found use for that yet. It'll rotate the plate 90 degrees. We'll go in and out. And once again, the traffic on off toggle. Now I have zoomed in just a little bit here. I've familiarized myself with all the notes at the top and the frequencies. And now I want to set up and get familiar with what I want the airplane to do. We're coming in from the northeast, top right side. And I actually am going to want to request from the centerman direct to Dubney. And that'll put me on the arrival. It is not one of the two preselected IAFs, however, so when I load my approach, I'll put it in the IAF, and then when I get my clearance that I request direct to Dubney, that will be in the flight plan, and I'll go there to basically just be a straight in to runway 23 at Gainesville. I'm looking now at the different setups. I'm just familiarizing myself with the approach right now, checking the LPVDA is 1720, missed approach altitude, 4,000 feet, direct to Zadat, and then we'll go to Womack. And a hole. That's just a missed approach procedure. We'll go in and set that up momentarily. Also, I alluded back where I could turn the traffic on and off. Now this, when the traffic is on, you will notice on the left side, it's got ABSB or GRF. Now the ABSB, I'm getting 8 stations right now. I can just glance at that on any of the plate screens, and if that's up there, the ABSB indication, I know I have traffic turned on. Another caveat about the traffic is, a lot of the GRF's plates only show the traffic inside the box of the bird's eye view of the approach. This system shows traffic in scale anywhere on the approach plate. For instance, you may have traffic pop up that's down in the minimums boxes, or the LPV is, or the airport diagram box. The traffic will be displayed there. It isn't scaled to the airport diagram, or the approach diagram. So you can toggle that off if that bothers you. If this is where you do it, it will not affect the traffic on any other of your map pages. Here you see it is off and the ABS annotation is gone. We return back now. I want to go to the home button, so I'll punch the right lower soft key and it will take me back to the screen. And it is time now to set up the EFIS for the approach. Now, what I've gone through just in the past few slides in reality has just taken me about 30 seconds to check the weather, pull up the approach plates, select the approach plate, and now I'm ready to review and brief the approach. To do that, I want to go to the screen and I will select PFD plate, which is one of the options now. And when I punch that, it brings up the plate on the right-hand side, displaces the map, and now the attitude indicator is over in the small portion of the screen. It's got just about all the information that's in the expanded view or the regular split screen. It does delete just a little bit of it for gravity. It's not anything we need. And it adds in the lower left-hand side, the 4 bottom boxes are programmable in the set menu, and you can tell it what you want to put. I have my engine indications down there. I have manifold pressure and RPM on the lower left, fuel total in volts in the lower right. That's my EFIS voltage and the fuel total remaining. Now, this is, once again, just pure technique. I like to know what my engine's doing, how much gas I got, and my airplane's totally dependent on electricity for shooting approaches, etc. So I want to make sure my alternator is still working. On the right side of the screen now, we can zoom in and out, set the plate where we want it. Once again, we're familiarizing ourselves. We'll brief the approach. We'll read all the notes, etc. in the top boxes. Look at all of our frequencies. We'll display the min safe in the sector altitude. Now we can see that it's got that displayed, all the bird's eye view and know where we're coming in. It's got the missed approach. We want to look at that, make sure we're familiar with the missed approach. We want to make sure we're familiar with all the minimums of our category class airplane. We're flying an LPV approach, so we'll familiarize ourselves with that. And then lastly, it's got the airport diagram displayed for situational awareness once we get on the ground. Now, if you push the plate key, that will bring up the manipulation keys for the plate, where I can zoom it left, right, up and down, in and out, where I can set the plate how I want to have it when I fly my approach. My preference is to zoom it in enough where I've already briefed myself on all the notes at the top. I know what I'm looking for with altimeter settings and circling minimums, etc., what's in that box. So this is what I like. I have the frequencies in case I need them across the top. I have the MSA circling view, the bird's eye view, the missed approach, the minimums that I'm going to fly. I can see the LPV BA in the bottom and the airport diagram. So once again, technique only. You can set it how you like it. This for me, with my weary old eyes, is where I can read everything and where it's most useful to me. So now let's continue on and let's set the aircraft up. We've reviewed and we've briefed our approach. Now let's set the airplane and the autopilot up. The first thing we want to do is set our minimums key. So to get to that, we go down to the more key in the bottom right. Let's hit more. And we will set up the BA and the missed approach bugs at that point. The more menu brings us into those. So here we go. Autopilot presets are one of the functions under the more key. So we want to set autopilot presets. And the first thing we want to do is set the decision altitude. So push that. Now we can see on our plate, 1720 feet is the LPV. The decision altitude box will begin flashing up here once you do the set the DA button. You use your altitude knob on the bottom right. This will not affect the altitude that the airplane's flying that you have selected. And we'll go ahead and set to 1720 feet. Roll it down to 1700, and then just wait for about 4 or 5 seconds if you want to really tweak it in, and the digits number will start flashing. At that time, you can go ahead and set 1720, then hit the set button, lower right, or the set knob, lower right side, push it. And then let's go, that'll take us back to the menu, and we'll bring this set to missed approach altitude. Same thing, you can spin the altitude knob down to 4,000 feet, which is our missed approach altitude. It's an even number, we don't have to wait and let anything start flashing to change it. So go ahead and push set, and that will set the missed approach altitude. And we want to go back now, that's the last thing we need to do for setting up our bugs. Back, that will take us back to the PFD plate page, and now we are still a long ways out. We haven't even begun our descent, so I don't really need to sit there and look at the plate page. So let's go home, and that will take us back to the map page. The next thing we need to do is activate the approach in our nav radio. Once again, purely technique, there are two ways to do this. You can load the approach, or you can activate the approach. Me personally, I like to go ahead and activate the approach. That way I don't have to worry down the road that I remember to do it. From this point on, once I activate it, I'm going to be flying the airplane in the heading mode, either following course or getting vectors from the controller. So let's go ahead and do that. The first thing we want to do, and this is a real foot stomper, I want to put the airplane in the heading mode. Now remember I said that as soon as I activate an approach, that is going to load it into the flight plan, and the airplane will start flying that. So if I stay in GNAV and activate the approach, the aircraft will immediately take off and go to one of the IAFs I select. That'll make the controller unhappy, and that's not a place I want to put myself. So I always go to the heading mode in the autopilot and let myself worry about taking the airplane where I want it to go then, and I start setting up the autopilot. So heading mode, and let's continue. Now we need to go into our 650 or whatever your nav radio is. In my case, here's the 650. And I want to activate the approach. And I do that by going to the procedures button. I want to select an approach. I want to select the RNAV23 GPS at Gainesville. And I am going to load one of the IAFs. And like I talked about earlier, I'm not going to go there, but I want to load the IAF and get the entire approach put into the flight plan, and then I'll go in and clean it up in the flight plan or the direct to button pages. So JTOX is one of the IAFs. I'm going to go ahead and select that. And there it is. Come in from the external flight plan. It loads JTOX Dubney. Now remember I said I wanted to go direct to Dubney. So my next point of action will be to get the controller either to listen if he's going to clear me for an IAF approach, or if, since I'm in radar environment, I'm going to request direct to Dubney and then a straight in for the runway 23 approach. Okay, we've done the first three. We've reviewed and briefed the approach. We've set the bugs through the more options and the set autopilot presets. We've activated the approach in the navigator radio that's driving the airplane. And now it's time to arm the autopilot for the approach. So to get into the autopilot menu, we push the right knob, and that brings us up to the autopilot selection menu. Notice, remember I said I went to the heading mode, so the lateral autopilot is in the heading mode at this time. Vertical is auto. And now I want to arm an approach for the GPS vertical LPV approach is what that is. And myself, I like to have as much help as I can get, as many backups as I can get. So I go ahead and arm the synthetic approach at the same time. So select the white boxes you want on all those, and then punch the accept or the exit button on the right side. Here's the exit button, and that will arm all the modes of the autopilot, and at that point, as soon as you hit exit, it brings up the execute mode. Now, this is something that we requested a while back that GRT was gracious enough to put in. Nothing that we've done to the autopilot now will make the airplane go anywhere until I push the execute button. When I push the execute button, it will go into the LPV mode or the synthetic approach mode. But as it is right now, it'll stay on the altitude I have dialed in, and it will stay on the heading that I have selected, or if we were still in GNAV, it would fly the GPS route, wouldn't do any altitude excursions or anything until I hear the words cleared for the approach from the controller. At that point is when I will push the execute button. Since I have armed the synthetic approach, it's going to ask me a couple questions. The synthetic approach is based purely on the runway end, both end identifier lat lines from the GPS, and it draws a glide slope from those points. So it wants to make sure that the airplane is at the same elevation that you think it is, hence it asks you to verify your altimeter setting so that the endpoints that it draws are actually going to take you to the end of the runway for the current altimeter setting. So we acknowledge that. If you have a arrival approach set into your navigator, it is also going to tell you that the GPS arrival is using the GPS to runway 23 instead of asking you what runway you want to in the synthetic approach. So in the IFR environment, if you have an approach selected, the synthetic approach will use the approach that you have selected. Now, if we were coming in VMC VFR and I said arm the synthetic approach, then it would flash a list of runways across the bottom, and it would predicate the one that it thought was right on the current winds that you're reading, and it will ask you if you want to do that. You can select any of the runways at the airport and hit arm, and that arms your synthetic approach for VFR flying. Okay, once again, we are back now. We're still a long ways out. We just got everything set up now, so I want to go back to the normal PFD, so I don't need to be looking at the plate, so let's push screen. And PFD, and that takes me back to either the full screen or the split screen. Now, we're still a long ways from destination. We've done a lot of button punching here, but we're just relaxing. Let's go back and recap just a little bit now. We've selected the approach, we've checked the weather, we have briefed the approach, we've set all the bugs, we've set the autopilot, and now we are ready when the man gives us a descent down. We're ready to start our descent, and we are ready to begin the approach whenever we hear the good old cleared for the approach terminology that we'll get. So let's call that into this section, and we'll pick up the next section once we get our clearance out of altitude.